Hello everybody and welcome to the fourth module of this course. We know that you have been working really hard on the course, so we wanted to use this video to recognize your work by mentioning a few best practices and good ideas that we have seen during module 3.
In module 3, we encourage you to create some games with Scratch, and we have seen that many teachers have already shared very nice projects in the Code Week Scratch Studio.
One of the projects is, for instance, the Shakespeare timeline made by Frini Marvel, where students can learn many things about Shakespeare. So, for instance, when and where was Shakespeare born, or what happened during the London Plague. This is a really good example of combining both Scratch and foreign languages, so very nice.
In the course discussion of Module 3, we also invited you to look through your curriculum for this year and consider where you could use visual programming in your teaching.
Fatima Lines from Portugal suggested, for instance, to use Scratch and storytelling so that her students could improve their English skills and make dialogue among the characters. Deception has many votes already, but you can still vote and add your own ideas on how to use Scratch in the classroom.
In the Padlet to participate in Code Week with Scratch, we have also seen many nice ideas of activities, such as the project Healthy Food for Our Dental Health, presented by Medap Kilic from Turkey. The one created by Artur Coelho in Portugal, where his fifth year students are using the microbits of Blockly to program robots, and many other projects, such as the projects Let's Help Greta Stop Climate Change, created by Matteo and Marcello in Schio, Italy. So, congratulations to Matteo, Marcello, Artur, Metap, Fatima and Frini for your work.
We are aware that all of you are working really hard to organize and share your projects with us, but unfortunately we are not able to mention all of them, so please do not feel disappointed if we don't mention your activity this time.
We hope you understand and we encourage you to keep sharing with us other examples of activities that might be worth mentioning in the upcoming modules.
In the fourth module of the course, we will ask you to share your experience when teaching robotics and we encourage you to give it a try and create different things such as a robotic hand or a paper circuit to encourage other teachers to get engaged in Code Week.
If you do the robotic hand or the paper circuit and want to share it with the rest of teachers, remember to publish it on the Facebook group and on Twitter with the hashtag CodeWeekDeepDive. If your paper circuit or any other inspiring activity gets our attention, we will also mention it in the next video. So we're looking forward to seeing your paper circuits to promote Code Week.
Finally, quick reminder that Code Week has officially started on the 5th of October and will continue until the 20th of October. But remember that you will have only until the 18th of October to register your activity if you want to get the course certificate.
Many thanks for your contribution and hard work.
And see you all in Module 4.